What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Learn Japanese from Some Guy. Got another beginner lesson for you. But before we begin, as always, please be sure to click that like button and subscribe if you haven't already, so you'll know when new videos are released, and click that bell and all that. So anyway, we'll get started with our kanji-based problem. So question number 16, we have to choose the correct kanji for the highlighted word here. So 毎日 日本語を勉強します. So how do we write 毎日 in kanji? So pause the video here, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is 2番 です. 毎日 日本語を 勉強します. So 毎日, every day, I study Japanese. 日本語を 勉強します. So the characters here obviously all look very similar. So the character that we saw in number one is the character for like ocean. And a little tip is if you see these three little dots here, this little radical, the kanji will almost always or usually have something to do with water, right? So this character means ocean. This character means every. This character right here actually means, you know, mother. And this character means poison, right? So maybe you got poisoned by your mother. I don't know. That's whoever came up with this character. I'm not sure how they decided. But anyway, this character here, every. So every sun, every day, 毎日. And actually, we're going to take a closer look at this character. So it can be read as my, as in 毎日, or goto. So we have words like 毎朝, so every morning, right? So here we have the character for every morning, 毎朝, every morning. 毎週, so here we have the character for week, so every week. 毎月, 毎月, every month. 毎年, 毎年, right? So you get the picture very easy. We just have some kind of time reference or time period. 毎年, 毎月, 毎月. It's all the same. And with goto, we can say, you know, for example, 5分 goto. So every 5 minutes. So we have some time frame, 10分, 5分, or whatever, goto. Every 5 minutes, 10分 goto. Every 10 minutes. So an extremely useful expression, really useful phrase, and a commonly used character too. You'll definitely want to remember it because you'll see it a lot. But moving on, now we'll take a look at our vocabulary. So number 17, we have to complete the sentence here to fill in the blank. So it says, これはまずくて美味しくて安くてつまらなくて食べられない. So pause the video here, choose an answer, and we'll check. Alright, so the answer is 1番 です. これはまずくて食べられない. So this, これは, this, maybe right here what they're looking at. まずい, bad tasting or gross. まずくて食べられない. So this is so bad tasting that I can't eat it. 食べられない. So it's gross, doesn't taste good, I can't eat it. So まずい, a very useful E adjective. But of course we need to change the E adjective まずい to the te form, right? まずくて, it's bad tasting, and, or as a result, 食べられない, I can't eat it. So we're going to take a little closer look at these vocabulary words here. Very useful. So first we saw まずい, so bad tasting, right? Not good. これはまずい, 美味しくない. So of course, 美味しい means something is good. The opposite of 美味しい is まずい. これはまずい, 美味しくない. This is not good. 安い, we saw cheap. So this is, you know, usually used for the price. You know, you wouldn't say like cheap quality as in like bad quality. This means cheap as in not expensive. So we can say, もっと安いのがありますか? So, もっと, more. もっと安い, a cheaper, more cheap, right? One, no, もっと安いの, a cheaper one, がありますか? So is there a cheaper one available? So maybe you're at like a store or something and you want to buy, I don't know, a pair of jeans or a car, and you're like, nah, もっと安いのがある? Like, is there a cheaper one I could buy? I'm still a little on the fence, and I don't have that much money. So, of course, the opposite of 安い is 高い, right? Expensive. And we saw in our vocabulary, or the choices, つまらない, boring, or like uninteresting. So we can say, for example, we have a sentence here, この映画はつまらないね. This movie is lame. つまらない, not cool. So of course the opposite of つまらない would be like 面白い. So 面白くない, つまらない, boring, lame. And finally, we'll take a look now at our 문법, our grammar. So number 18, we have to complete the sentence here. So we can say 誰が, 誰か, 誰でも, 誰も, フランス語ができる人はいませんか? So pause the video here, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is 2番 です. 誰か. 誰か フランス語ができる人はいませんか? 誰か フランス語ができる人はいませんか? So is there anyone here that can speak French? France. So France is the name of the country. So a lot of times with Japanese, it's very easy. You just add go, right, after the country. So Spain go, Spanish, Deutsch go, German, France go, Nihon go, Chugoku go. Of course, we don't say America go. We say ego because it comes from England. But anyway, so you can't say, you know, for every country, but a lot of the times you just add go to the country. So 誰か, someone, anyone. Is there anyone here that can parlez-vous français? So we're going to take a look at using 誰 and its multiple usages. And of course, 誰 by itself means like who, right? Who. So 誰か would be like someone or anyone. And here we have a sentence. 道を迷ったら, so if you get lost on the road or something, 誰か助けてくれるかな? Somebody, 誰か, anyone. I wonder if anyone will help me if I get lost. So maybe, you know, you're traveling in Japan and you wonder, ah, 助けてくれる人はいるかな? 誰か助けてくれるかな? Will someone help me? Anybody, 誰か. Next we have 誰でも, which means like anyone, like it doesn't matter, everyone. So here we have a sentence. 勉強したら誰でも日本語をできるようになるよ。頑張って. So if you 勉強したら, so if you study, 誰でも, anyone can learn Japanese. So, you know, don't think Japanese too hard. 誰でもできる. Anybody, right? Something anyone can do. So we just have, you know, 誰 and 誰でも. So this is a common expression or common structure, you know, with like WH words, like who, what, where, 何でも, どこでも, いつでも. It just means like anyone, anywhere, いつでも, anytime, 何でも, anything, right? So 誰でも, anyone, everyone. So, of course, you don't want to confuse 誰か and 誰でも. So, in this sentence, you know, 道を迷ったら誰でも助けてくれるかな? That doesn't really make sense, right? 誰か, like, I wonder if there's someone there. I'm not sure, right? 誰か, 誰か助けてくれるかな? And finally, we have 誰も, nobody. 誰もパーティーに来なかった. Ah, nobody came to my party. Oh, no. So, here again, just like we saw 誰も, we can add 誰も to, you know, WH words. So, 誰も, like, who, mo, nobody. I'm not sure how we get the meaning, but you know, 誰も means nobody. いつも means always. 何も means like nothing. 何もないよ, like there is nothing. So you'll often see mo after some of these words, you know, 誰, いつ, どこ, どこも, wherever. Okay? So 誰も パーティーに来なかった. And you know, it's negative, so you want to use, you know, you can't say 誰も パーティーに来た. Like, you need a negative, right? Nobody came. 来なかった. But that's it for our grammar lesson. So just using 誰, 誰か, 誰でも, 誰も. Okay, useful expressions, pretty easy. But you'll definitely want to, you know, practice using them. So, you know, try writing a sentence in the comments, see how you do. But that's going to do it for today's lesson. So as always, thank you guys for liking, watching, subscribing. If you want to learn, you know, more in-depth grammar, you can check out my book on Amazon. The description is in the... A link is in the description below. And if you have any comments or questions, you know, I'd be happy to answer them. So let me know what you guys think. If you have any questions, I'll try to help you as best as I can. But that's going to do it for today. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Matane.